嗨，大家好，我是主持人饶顺。今天我们很荣幸的邀请到了来自乔治华盛顿的一位女士来参加我们的节目，她的名字叫做 Georgette Edmondson-Wright。Hi, Ms. Wright, welcome to AllenTalk, welcome to China.
And nice to meet you, thank you for welcoming me.
Likewise. Yeah, could you please first introduce yourself a little bit more to our audience?
Sure. So I'm Georgette Edmondson-Wright, I'm Associate Provost for Strategic Enrollment at the George Washington University, which is a large private research university in Washington, D.C.
Very good. So is this your first time here in China?
It is actually my fifth trip to China, fifth trip to Beijing, but I'm going to, on this trip, be visiting a few cities with a few colleagues, and I hope to visit some new cities where I've never visited.
Good. Yeah. What's your impression of China?
China continues to impress. I think it's such a growing economy, and you sort of see that when you're here. You see a lot of wealth, but you also see a lot of old China, and I think I really like the confluence of that. Mm-hmm. When I come to Beijing, I see what I think Beijing was like many, many years ago. People riding bicycles, very hard-working communities, but you also see a new growing, I would say, middle class in China as well. It's going to continue to move in that direction.
So, very good. Yeah. Thank you. And can you tell us more about what brings you here in China this
certainly.
Time?
Yes, certainly. So I'm an educator, and part of the work that I do with my colleagues is international collaboration and outreach. Oh. And we are interested very much in continuing our partnerships with Chinese universities, with high schools that send their students also to the United States, and with programs that are interested in receiving students from our universities here in China. So we're actually here as part of a five-city tour around China. We're going to be starting here in Beijing. I think we're wrapping up our week in Beijing. Mm-hmm. We're going to Shenyang, to Shanghai, Chengdu, and Guangzhou. Ah. We will work a little bit with the State Department's Education USA office. We will visit some universities. We will meet with high school counselors and parents. And our goal is to sort of promote opportunities for collaboration, mutual collaboration, as well as hopefully attract some more Chinese students to our wonderful universities.
Yeah, definitely, without a doubt.
Yeah.
And it's a trip from the north to the south of China. Right?
Yes, from cold to hot.
Yes.
So packing was a challenge. I brought a winter coat, just, you know.
Yeah. Yeah, we'd love to hear more about the George Washington
University.
Yeah, and you know, every university has a motto.
Yes.
Yeah, I know Yale's motto is like light and truth.
Yes.
How about George Washington? What's the motto of George Washington University?
So George Washington, we characterize it by saying knowledge in action.
Knowledge in action.
Knowledge in action, and I think that says a lot. I mean, we are. We're a major research university, and we're in Washington, D.C. Washington, D.C., being, you know, the capital city of the United States, brings a very sort of unique set of experiences and resources to our educational experience. We are in a city that is the number one city for government organizations, for nonprofit organizations, for international organizations. And our students who come from all around the country and all around the world are students who are really interested in service and in doing. We have already nine members of our university alumni who are standing members of Congress.
Wow.
We are number one in internships.
Wow,
yes, good. We 50% or 40 to 50% of our students will study abroad, so it's very international facing. And our students like to volunteer. Last year, we logged over 650,000 hours of community service and volunteerism.
To help the community.
So even though we have exceptionally strong programs in School of Business and International Affairs and Public Policy, which are big, big programs at the university, a strong School of Engineering, so much of what makes GW a GW school is the opportunity to connect it to the community locally and globally.
Wow, good. So the knowledge and action are really applied in every aspect.
It's an absolutely applied experience. And I think that the student that comes to GW is someone who really sees himself as being a hands-on leader. Our students are very, very different. It's not uncommon for our average student to have 1 to 2 internships before they graduate from GW, and that would include international students.
Many students from China?
Yes, we do. We have about 15% of our students are international, but a good number of those are from China. And Chinese students add a lot to our cultural climate and our campus climate. We have two Chinese student associations, so they're very active on campus. And we're seeing more and more students from different parts of China coming to our university as well.
Good, good.
Yeah.
So based on your experience, how are the Chinese students doing at your university?
I'm going to say I think they're doing great. Well, because we're seeing certainly more students. And I think when you see more students coming to university, that is an indication that students are feeling well-supported academically and personally. And it also means that there's a community already there that they relate to. And I think it's very important for students to find community with other students. Our Chinese students are very, very active. I mean, they study and they're very, very good students. But that aside, they have their clubs and their communities and their organizations. In my office alone, I have two Chinese students who are student volunteers. They work in my, they get paid, they're not volunteers. They're student office assistants in my office. And they are really, really wonderful. They help us with translations for our programs, with tours for our programs. We had the privilege of hosting USIEA and some delegate universities from China on our campus about 3 weeks ago. And I relied on our Chinese students to help with translations and tours and taking our guests around campus. Hardworking, and they'll always say yes, and they'll always help. So we've had fantastic and wonderful experiences with our Chinese students.
That's great. We're really glad to hear that.
And if I could say one more thing,
of course,
the other thing is we have many, many alumni, graduates of our universities, who come back to China. So when we come to China to do any of our work, they help to host our events. So this Saturday I'm going to an event and one of our Chinese alumni will come and be a translator at a table and talk to parents with me. So they're very committed and engaged and committed to the work that they do and that we do at GW.
Excellent. Good, good. Wow. I'm really glad to hear that. They're really doing a great job, and that's something that what they're doing is really making us feel proud.
Makes us feel proud too.
Excellent, excellent. Yes. As for those students who want to go to study at GW, what advice can you give to them?
So for students who want to study at GW, I would say do your research, whether you're an undergraduate student or a graduate student. There are so many universities, so many wonderful universities in the United States and around the world, that the best way to make a decision is to find what we call the right fit. And the right fit isn't just about rankings. That doesn't tell the whole story. And all of us have ranked programs. What they really need to think about is where will I feel that I can make a difference? And where will I feel that I can be accepted and validated and learn? So you're looking for your academic programs, you're looking for the location and what the location offers in terms of opportunities to work or to internship. You want to look at the student body. If you have the time and the resources, it's great if you can visit, because that's very different than what you see on a website and what you read in a book, is to be able to experience the campus. Or if you can't do that, to contact a student and talk to a student about that experience. I think the most successful student is a student who has found a place where they'll feel well supported. And well supported means that they know that they will have peers and teachers and faculty who will look out for them, a place where they feel that they can manage and navigate, and a place where not only can they be academically successful, but socially successful. And one of the things that we do know as educators, and we've been paying attention to this, is that particularly students from China sometimes feel that they can't make friends with Americans.
Because they're more reserved?
Reserved, maybe language differences, cultural differences. So it's really, really important, we say to students, to get involved at the very beginning. And in fact, when our students from China talk to other students about how to do that, they say the most important thing to do is to get involved in clubs and organizations and roommates. Take a friend, someone from China and someone not, and go out and do things with them. And that's the way you learn to adjust in a new environment.
Very good. To experience new things, right?
Experience new things. Be open-minded to new things. Yeah. Yes, exactly.
Very good, very good. So any other advice you can give to them, how they can be better prepared before they go study abroad?
Before they go to study abroad,
in the university?
Yes, certainly. Well, I would say a couple of things. As I said, I think it's always important to get a sense of what to be prepared for. And the greatest assets that we have as a university are our graduates. Mm-hmm. So we all universities will have alumni here in Beijing and in other parts of China. Mm-hmm. To sit with those alumni and to talk to them about what their experiences were and to learn from them, learn from others who have been through that experience. Mm-hmm. And also to find people that when they come to the United States, that they have people they can continue to talk to. I think it seems very intimidating sometimes for a student to reach out to someone they don't really, really know. people are really friendly. I think sometimes if you just make the effort, reach out and say, hi, I'm new. I would like to talk to you. I'd like to talk to you about how to choose my classes. We'll put you in touch with an advisor. I'd like to talk to you about how to find my way around campus. We'll put you in touch with a student. But finding a peer or a resource that is an administrator or faculty member, I think we want to help. We care about our students. And I think making the personal connection is especially important.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Personal connection, also initiate to study and to ask questions.
Right. Yeah, and not to be shy, you know.
There's no
need to be shy. And even before they go, when we were talking about pre-departure, I would say the other thing that Chinese students really learn very quickly when they come to the United States is that the classroom culture is very different. Mm-hmm. You know, the teachers in U.S. classrooms are very, they expect you to participate. And in fact, many professors expect you to participate, otherwise your grade will suffer. So it's so important.
You cannot stay silent.
You cannot stay silent.
You have to participate, to interact with the
professors. Which is very natural if you didn't grow up that way, right?
Ah.
So group work, participating, holding up your hand, volunteering an answer, which sometimes people feel might be uncomfortable or might embarrass somebody else, is very, very common in the United States.
Based on my experience, I studied in China before. It's kind of like to be a good student is to memorize, not all the time.
Right.
Most time is to be a good student to memorize everything teacher teaches you.
Right.
And not to say no.
Right, which is not the US way. You say, well, I'm not sure, I'd like to understand more. And they expect you to be very active participants in the classroom. So that's a big learning curve.
Can we call that kind of like the also focus on the critical thinking? Really important?
Critical thinking, feeling it's okay to disagree, which is a hard thing to do if you've not been taught to disagree. But you can disagree respectfully, and Chinese students are very respectful.
Mm-hmm. As long as you're able to justify yourself.
Exactly, right? Exactly. Mm-hmm. So to be able to express a different opinion respectfully and to be heard. And I think professors really value that sort of analytic thinking and very dynamic thinking. They're not interested in people repeating, sort of what they've learned. So
very good. We want people to really, sometimes the students also help the professor, right?
Yes.
Help the certain area of knowledge to grow with the critical thinking.
Which is why we really value international students in our classroom. Mm-hmm. All of our students bring very diverse experiences, U.S. students and other students. Mm-hmm. But what's especially important about having a diverse and an international classroom is you get a diversity of opinions and a diversity of experiences. Mm-hmm. And we want to have those very respectful and very important dialogues. It makes for a richer academic experience.
Very good, very good. Yeah, I totally agree. Yeah, really good and also very useful to our Chinese audience to hear and know. Right?
Yes, yes.
Yeah, because of a different culture, different background, definitely there will be a different perspective. Then it can generate different opinions, right?
Yes,
yeah,
yes.
To make it more diversified.
Right. Mm. I find Chinese students, one thing I would say about Chinese students, it's a very, it's a culture where there are clear benchmarks for success.
Mm-hmm.
Test scores, rankings, you know, these things are very, very important in Chinese culture. Not so much in American culture.
Yeah, what's American culture like?
American culture is more about what you get out of the experience. It's much more individually driven.
Mm-hmm.
So while grades are always important, we really want students to find the experience that brings the best out in that student, right? And that can be in the classroom, that can be in volunteering in the community, that can be participating in a student organization. It's the wealth of the experience itself that makes for an important experience at the university.
Yeah.
And our most successful students are not all about A's and B's and grades.
Mm-hmm.
That's important.
Mm-hmm.
But they're also about making the most of all the other experiences and opportunities that a university provides.
Very good. So it's not all just about grades. You know? It's really about all the experiences.
Yes.
All experiences can teach you to be your best teacher.
Yes.
The richer your experience is, the richer you become.
Right. I like to share a story that someone shared with me once.
Okay. I'd love to hear that.
Yeah, and it had to do with one of our former presidents. So this is our president from many years ago, President Ronald Reagan. Mm-hmm. And someone said to me, "Do you know what university President Ronald Reagan went to?" I had no idea. He went to a little tiny college called Juniata College. I believe it's in Illinois. Yeah, it's a tiny little school. It's a small little school.
Okay.
And he became the president of the United States.
The ranking was not.
No ranking was not. And it's not even a big university. It's a small little university, mm-hmm. which goes to show that what you make of the experience is what matters.
Exactly. Yeah.
Yeah.
Wow. Very good. Well said.
Yeah.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
So. How long have you been working at the
George Washington?
Yeah.
I've been working at George Washington continuously since 2003. So I can't do the math.
14 years.
I think we're up at 14 years. I've been in higher ed longer than that at private and public universities around the United States, but Washington D.C. has been my home since 2003.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow, that also shows how dedicated that you are with the education.
I think it's a fantastic university. I found, many of them are, but I really respect that university, and I've had great experiences there, and I love their international-facing mission.
Good.
Yeah.
And also, I know you also visited many universities in China as well, right?
Yeah.
So by comparison, you know, some universities in China, the educational system with the George W. University, have you found some differences or some similarities?
So I'm not a faculty member, an administrator, right?
Oh,
so
okay.
I don't sit on the classroom side mm-hmm. of things. I find administratively that the bureaucracies are different. You have to navigate a little more here on the bureaucracies here.
Okay.
I think the offices are a bit different and they're structured differently. In the United States, we place a lot of value on sort of student services. Mm-hmm. So we have a whole unit dedicated just towards student affairs. And we don't find that at all Chinese universities, at some Chinese universities, yes, but not all Chinese universities.
Mm-hmm.
But I found them to be very collaborative. In fact, George Washington has a program that we're very proud of.
Wow.
It's with Fudan University in Shanghai,
mm-hmm.
and it's our global BA program. And so these are GW students who come and they will spend their second semester studying in Shanghai,
mm-hmm.
So that we really think that students benefit from having opportunities to study in different educational settings
mm-hmm.
outside of the US, and particularly in China.
Oh, very good,
mm-hmm.
very good.
Mm-hmm.
And also, also know you're here this time also promoting like a
Short-term programs, summer
maybe
programs.
Maybe you can tell us a bit about that as well?
I'd be happy to.
Yeah.
So we're promoting specifically summer programs on this tour because many of our universities and my colleagues who are here with me from the Association of University Summer mm-hmm. Sessions, we have summer programs for our own students, but we also open up our classrooms in the summer where we have capacity and space to visiting international students.
How many seats have you left for international students?
So we don't reserve a certain number of seats, but we have space,
uh-huh.
you know. So our programs are some credit bearing, some non-credit bearing programs,
mm-hmm.
And they're undergraduate and they're graduate. They're all different levels.
Okay.
Some of them are focused on research. Some of them are focused on engineering and business.
Mm-hmm.
But we want students to be able to come into a classroom for a short-term experience, have classes with U.S. students, learn the language better, experience Washington, D.C. They live in resident halls together with other students.
Mm-hmm.
And we provide a lot of residence activities.
Hall.
Yeah, we don't use the word dormitory anymore. I hear dormitory sometimes, but we got away from that
long ago.
Yeah. It's a little more than sleeping. Dormitory is to sleep. Residence is more about community.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
So they live in the resident halls together, and then they spend the evenings and the weekends in social and cultural activities
mm-hmm.
to introduce them to the United States. But the goal isn't just to introduce them to GW. The goal is to expose them to another culture, another
mm-hmm.
way of doing. It helps our students be better students. It helps our students be more globally minded, and it helps other students get to know other people.
Yeah,
so.
Oh, very good. Sounds quite interesting.
I'm sure
it's going to interest a lot of Chinese students who like to participate.
It's really wonderful to listen to them at the end of the summer. I think students find, no matter how short these programs are, they find them to be what the word is, transformative. Mm-hmm. You know, they didn't know what to expect. They had an idea, but then they come in and they discover much more about themselves
just
than they ever knew.
Go and do it.
Just well, go and do it. Just do it. I think that's Nike.
Experience of transformation. That's Nike.
That's right.
Just do as Nike does.
Yeah, that's right.
Nice, nice. So. Can you also tell us about, because there are also some other, I heard of some other summer programs or short-term programs, study abroad programs out there. How does your program differentiate from other programs?
So I'm assuming you're talking about other university programs, because there are other businesses that do this too.
Yeah.
So from a university point of view, I think every program is as distinct or as unique as the university itself. Mm. So GW is a very different kind of an institution than University of Pennsylvania or University of California, Berkeley. Mm. They're all very good programs, but they're very different programs. Mm-hmm. And so the summer program will reflect usually the strengths of that particular university. Mm-hmm. Academically, it will reflect the resources or the benefits of the particular region. Mm-hmm. If you go to a summer program in a small rural area, it's going to feel different than a big city like Washington, D.C. Mm-hmm. And that's not a good or a bad. It really depends what the student... It's a different experience and what the student is looking for. Mm-hmm. I think what's most important is that wherever you go, whether it's in a large city or a small climate, or if you're looking for an Ivy League or a ranked university, that what you're really looking for is a supportive environment, mm-hmm. because you want to have a good experience.
Exactly.
That's what
you
matters.
Want to make the best of the experience.
Make the best of the experience. And I always like to say to our parents, in particular our parents from China, they think a lot about safety.
Oh yeah, that's
and they think a lot
safety.
Safety, and I know you get a lot of news, and you hear the one or two stories that make it sound like all of the terrible things are happening in the U.S. There, you know, of course, you know, you want to be careful in any major city, mm-hmm. But programs generally are safe. Our programs at George Washington are quite safe. We've never had an incident with a student on our campus. Mm-hmm. I like to brag that because we're four blocks from the White House, we're protected by the same people that protect the president, so we have a lot of protection.
<I see. laughs>
Plus, we have our own police and Washington, D.C. police and the police of the waters and the police of the forests. There are a lot of police. So it's a very safe environment. It's a city, so you're always smart and practice safety in a city, but I would say to Chinese parents, we have a lot of Chinese students and it's a safe campus.
Mm, good, good. Thank you so much for sharing that with us. Maybe before we finish up here, do you have any other words you want to say to our audience?
I would like to say thank you for welcoming me into your homes. I'm assuming this is in your home or maybe on your laptop or your computer. I'm not quite sure. But that if you come to Washington, D.C., we will support you. We will make this a wonderful experience for you. And we will engage you in a very full GW experience, which is only can be had in Washington, D.C. We like to say hashtag only at GW.
Only at GW.
Hashtag only at GW.
Thank you so much for taking
the interview. You're welcome. Thank you for the interview.
You're welcome. Okay. Wish you all the best.
Thank you.